And now for the other team. Without further ado, Mr. SaberSpark. You may know him from Bronies React. I'm sure he'll be reacting to him today. ACRacebest. I said ACRacebest. Oh, there it is. Leave it. And last, but certainly not least, the one, the only, Black Griffin. Professional as always. All right, well, this first game is for the this is for those guys, for Saber and his team.
Team Hash Brown.
And this first game is called Number of Words. Now the way this is gonna work is that I'm going to assign a character and a number of words to each of those four poor unfortunate souls. And they're gonna have to act out a scene only using a select number of words. So, for example, Mr. Black Griffin, you are going to be playing Discord. And every time you speak, you have to use exactly four words. ACRacebest, you are going to be playing a diamond dog. You have two words to work with. Beepins. You will be playing Queen Chrysalis. You have five words to work with. SaberSpark, you will be Lord T-Rex. You have three words to work with. The scene is the Legion of Pony Doom scheming their next evil plot.
Mine works.
No.
Mine does not work. Oh, yes, it does.
Do you need a refresher? Do I need to tell you?
Number of words.
You got it?
Yeah. My mic works good.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
Right. Let it begin. I welcome you, y'all.
Thank you very much.
Have the eggs been laid?
Rough, rough. Put him there.
Chocolate milk, nuclear weapons.
I like that.
Evil things, they're all I.
Who are you?
Kibbles Bits. I like that idea.
So what's up?
Not much. How about you?
Not bad, homie. Hey, you dog.
What? Do.
Sit down here.
Okay.
Let's talk plan. I need submissions.
You took my power.
I'm bored.
Got the carpet.
Finish a whole complete sentence.
Where is Sombra?
He
has gone.
What a loser he is.
I have no plans.
I got.
What is your plan?
Good one.
I have Swiss cheese legs.
Tell me your plan.
We go.
Yes, and then we
stop go.
This doesn't help. We must.
I agree, you. My love.
Off my leg.
You want to hook up?
many different animals?
You. Can't count with just... my paw. My cloven hoof leg.
Shake tail.
No, thank you.
We never get anything done.
Good meeting, guys. Squirrel, squirrel.
Much better than last year.
I'm going to assign 1,000 points to ACRacebest for just sheer tercity.
It's such a waste of vocabulary!
All right, well, this next game is for our hashtag NotHorseFamous team. This game is called Superheroes. So I need somebody from the audience to yell out a random superhero. The way this is gonna work, we're gonna start off with Wiggles. You're gonna start up. You are going to be Squirrel Girl. You're gonna be acting out as Squirrel Girl, attending her first convention. And one by one, starting with Headliner, and then Brian, and then Andrew, you are gonna each go up on stage. She is going to name who you are, and you will have to act accordingly. So, reset. Squirrel Girl, take it away.
All right, I see here on my squirrel monitor, let me just punch in my acorn buttons and see what's... Oh, no! Oh, it looks like all of the acorns in the entire Equestria have gone missing. I need those. I'll have to call in my friends. Beep, boop, beep, boop. Oh, I'm so glad you're here, Muffin Man.
I can help you recover the acorns. It took me a while to get here from Mulberry Lane, but...
It's a hard trip, yes.
Yes, it is. So, all the acorns have gone missing.
All of them.
All of them?
Yeah.
You've checked the ground.
Yeah.
Oh. Okay. All the acorns?
Oh, good. It's Lightbulb Lad. Lightbulb Lad. You will get... all the acorns! Lightbulb Lad needs to work on his anger management issues. No more acorns, trees! No more trees! I like the trees! I can't be a tree hugger! I can't hug Fluttershy anymore! If there's no trees!
You look like you could use some help.
Oh, thank God you're here, Captain Dubstep!
I think to find the acorns, we need to whop them out of the audience.
I can make to this.
I don't think this is working.
We gotta crank this to 11.
Okay.
Pump up the bass!
Okay, how do you do that?
Alright, so we need to figure out how to get these acorns back. I'm making muffins, don't worry.
Are they acorn muffins?
They're not acorn muffins.
Are they dubstep muffins?
We're trying to find those.
Are they dubstep muffins?
They can be.
All right.
They should be. We should play some
muffins.
Somebody
better invite Dorothy.
What?
She likes muffins.
She does. Would she know where the acorns would be?
You know what? I think she would.
I just don't know what went wrong.
Cover up on the squirrel phone right
here.
Use
the squirrel phone.
It's an actual squirrel. That's what it is.
Is that getting good reception?
Yeah. Just to...
Surprising.
Now this next game here is one that I have been looking forward to immensely. This I'm really excited for. It's called Dead Bodies. Now, the way this is going to work, B-Vids, I'm sorry, you are going to be today's puppeteer. The way this works is that the scenario is that these guys are going to be playing a play about it's cider season, and it's going to be a scene where they have to make as much cider as they can in order to be Flim and Flam. However, in the course of this play, the actors have died, but the show must go on. So poor B-Bitch is going to have to manipulate ACRacebest and Saber Spark's bodies to act out the characters. So ACRacebest, poor limp corpse, is going to be Applejack. Saber Spark is going to be Granny Smith. And about a minute into the scene, Black Griffin will walk in, he will be Flim, and he will promptly die. Everybody understand the rules? All right, let's get this going. So. Okay. Dead bodies, not convulsing. The scenario is that it is apple cider season, and Applejack and Granny Smith are trying to make enough cider to save their farm, and yeah.
Granny Smith, I can't believe that we're not gonna have enough apples this year.
Sell the farm this time, like the great winter of 96. I don't know if I can live through another winter like that. We had to eat our own. Why don't you get your big brother to help out? You know he's useless like a sack of dead rats. He was homeschooled for a reason. Not in front of Apple Bloom! She's old enough to know.
Well, look who we got, dear brother of mine.
Quit raising bonds. Quit raising bonds. Cider than you, because we're better than you. You dirty mongrel earth ponies. Who do you call it, dirty mongrel earth ponies? Yeah. We're not dirty. Then it's settled. We'll pick apples at dark. It's happening again. What do you mean? Granny Smith made a mess in the bed again.
Would you get apple baby
help clean up? My God, you're not even worth my time. I'm going to Appaloosa. I hear there's an orange pony who likes to fight.
And most awkward death. All right. Now, this next game is called Let's Make a Date. our team, hashtag not horse famous. The way this is going to work is that headliner will be the available bachelor. And I'm going to hand the other three performers their roles. They won't know what each other's roles are. They will reveal them at the end of the segment. Here you go. And you can move the chairs appropriately. Of course, as you guys know, in any game, the bachelor will be asking questions of the respective mates.
Game 7.4 day!
What's so better, like last victory?
Hello.
Hey. Hey.
All right, so, gonna ask you guys questions. Bachelor number one, what is your ideal first date?
Well, my ideal first date would be somewhere where there's a lot of ponies around that I can go and make really close friends with.
The menacing laughter, that was a nice touch. Bachelor number two, same question.
Repeat the question.
What is your ideal first date?
You know, sometimes I just want to focus on just one thing and, you know, exploit it as much as possible. So, you know, we might just go out to dinner for that same restaurant for, you know, the next, you know, year or so. I hope you like pizza.
I love pizza. That's great. All right, bachelor number three, same thing.
My first day would be anywhere but this place. You know, somewhere safe. This is definitely not the most ideal place. I can probably guess that the walls will be closing in about 5 minutes and there will be no survivors. So we better get out of here and get on that date right away.
Oh, wow. Yeah. That's heavy stuff out there. That's like a fortune cookie. All right, next question.
Oh, sorry. I was distracted.
It could be dangerous. It could trigger something off.
Bachelor number one.
Stop it!
If you were any food, what food would you be? And what?
Oh, I'm sorry, you were asking me a question. I was just really distracted.
The contestants are hard of hearing. Bachelor number one, if you were any type of food, what food would you be and why?
Well, I would be something that would be melty and squishy and really tasty.
What are you eating, blue? Bachelor number two, same question.
Yeah, what would you be?
It kind of depends on what everyone else has in schedule. You know, I mean, I just work for some people. You know, I have jobs to do. I mean, I just kind of exploit everything.
I love that.
All right. Bachelor number three.
If I were any kind of food, I'd probably be some sour, like Sour Patch Kids, because I'm very explosive, and I think this place is too.
All right.
There's something fishy going on here, I promise you all.
Please, I work for children.
That's okay, I like children.
We should probably be moving towards an exit sometime soon.
And now, bachelor number one, if I was on my deathbed, what would be your final words to me?
What is this guy's number?
Alrighty, bachelor number two.
Well, you'd probably sell out, to me, obviously. I mean, like, you probably have, you know, some kind of big fan base that, you know, both demographics might want your ashes. Just might want to warn you about that.
Okay.
I love that answer.
Not entirely sure what that means. Bachelor number three, same question.
I'm sorry, repeat the question. I was making sure the place is safe.
Each one of these guys, what would your final words to me on my deathbed be?
stay crazy, and stay alive. And always check the boomboxes.
Okay. Bachelor number one. What is your favorite color?
Green? Or red? Or flesh color? I'm really into flesh color. You could say I love it.
Alright. Bachelor number two. Well, during this season, I've been very into the rainbow color. No, all about the rainbows, you know. That's what I'm trying to focus my demographic on, you know, rainbows. All right, and bachelor number three. Bachelor number three, are you there?
I'm sorry, what?
Your favorite color, bachelor number three.
Oh, it's definitely, kind of like a olive greenish and kind of like a very, kind of like a muted yellow, I'd say.
All right.
Sorry, I'm not going to...
All right. With bachelors 1, 2, and 3, or bachelorette 1, bachelorette 1, 2, 3, please reveal who you are.
I was a chrysalis who is in love with contestant number 2.
I was a Hasbro executive.
I was Daring Do, who thinks that this is a trap.
Yeah! I've got to say, I picked Bachelor number 2, because then I could change the show.
Oh, we just want Flash Century out of here, don't you? This is definitely a setup. This is definitely a setup.
And I am going to assign 5,000 points to Wiggles for most awkward Hester ever. Is for Teen Hashtag, or Hash Browns Hashtag, whatever. And it's called Greatest Hits, and for this we're gonna need some musical accompaniment. So do we have our musicians on here? It's gonna take a second to set up. The way that this is going to work is that Saber Spark, Saber Spark, singularly. Saber Spark AC Race. Oh, you're here? Yeah, there we go. Everybody, round of applause for Basic. We're going to get our resident musicians today. The way this is going to work is that Saber Spark and AC RaceBest and B-Fits are going to be. Basically like an infomercial describing a album of greatest hits about a random topic. I need a random topic from the audience.
Thank y'all.
This little song about my life.
To Buck.
A country song, the likeness of Applejack.
Exactly.
I have to sing this
too.
Yeah.
This is a beautiful
my
country
name is
song.
Buck, and I came here to Buck.
Rated G, right?
Yep. No, rated Y7.
That's my name. I can't remember. It's not what you might think it means. Maybe it is. Yes, I don't know what you think it means.
So I'll just
show you. This is Bucket. I came in the book.
What a fantastic song. That one got me through the summertime back in 96.
Brings tears to my eyes just thinking about it.
The next song is album. I heard it's a very intense rock song.
Oh, it is very much one of my personal favorites. It's actually called The Apples Are Eating My Face.
What is your favorite thing about The Apples Are Eating My Face?
Well, I feel like the lyrics are really relatable.
My favorite part is how intense the dance moves are.
Highly choreographed. Years of practice to get this down.
I can't wait to hear it.
There's so many apples that could eat your face.
You just never know.
Granny Smith.
The other day, I was sitting on my toilet, thinking about the things that happened to me. And then, I thought, what if something happened? Something really weird. That's not relatable at all. What if apples ate my face? This is what I'd say.
Some dance moves that I think will pick up just like Gangnam Style.
Yeah. I hope so.
Well, our next song is changing up quite a bit. It's actually an opera rock ballad.
I heard the song. The song is "I Am Not Octavia."
One of my favorite things about that is that she is not, in fact, Octavia.
Yeah, you can really just insert yourself into the story. It's like an OC fanfic.
I can only hear opera song from guitars.
Yeah. It's all about the voice, really. The guitars just kind
of... As a matter of fact, is that even physically possible? I guess so.
It's an opera rock ballad.
Oh,
child.
This next game is for hashtag team not horse famous. This is called multiple personalities. I'm gonna need three prop savers. If you go grab those for me, please.
Oh, he fell!
Is he all right?
So much blood! Oh! Oh, sorry, it's okay, it's this. Thanks, everyone.
All right. So the way this is gonna work, the way this is going to work is that each of these props is going to represent a different personality. That charming prop that you have on your head there, sir, is going to be representative of Maud Pie. That beautiful pair of wings appropriately will represent Princess Twilight Sparkle. I can't see a third prop. Oh, sunglasses. All right, sunglasses are gonna represent Pinkie Pie. And headliner is a human dropped into Equestria. Oh. Now, during the course of this game, props may switch, and as the props switch or as they're handed off, the personalities will also have to be handed off as well. Let's take it away. Hey, give him a round of applause.
Today to see my coronation, the second one, because I wanted to have another. I don't have any rocks, no, I'm sorry. I'm so excited! Are you gonna throw me a big party?
I'm gonna throw you a bunch of parties!
Man, that's gonna be great!
I'm also gonna throw you a bunch of cupcakes, so keep your eyes out for that.
Okay, I guess so.
That's so cool. Oh,
2 seconds.
We're there, Toaster!
It's me.
Oh! I've never met you before! My name's Pinkie Pie!
Ponies!
No, let's go get the rest of us!
I've never seen anything like you before.
Let me get a better one.
Hold these.
Royal duty is to find out who this creature is. Hi.
Oh my God.
I really like humans.
That's probably at the service.
Maud, please try to contain your excitement.
Wings.
Oh yes, you can touch them. They're kind of new though, so be careful. Oh.
Wings.
What kind of rocks do you have in your world?
What is your name?
My name's, Julie.
Julie? I'm Maud Pie. It's very nice to meet you. Dear Maud, we've met. Do you not remember me?
That's the princess, sis. Come on!
I am the new princess.
princess.
I'm sorry, I can't see very well.
Now, do you know where the mess hall is?
The mess hall?
I don't think we have any of that, but I have some cupcakes!
Good, Oliver is hungry.
No, maybe I'll just fly there myself.
Signing 2,000 points to poor Brian for destroying his voice with that Pinkie Pie impression. Alright, this next game is for Team Hash Browns. Your Hash Brown, hashtag Hash Brown. And it's one of my personal favorites. It's called Irish Drinking Song. Once again, joined by the esteemed musicians, Mr. D.B. Pony and Mr. Basic. Theme.
Oh no.
Let's start off this round. First round, we'll do two rounds. First round will be the theme of Bronycon. Bronycon. That's where we are.
We are? What are you going to tell me? Oh my goodness.
Wait, the theme is Bronycon?
Yes.
And having fun? What this is?
It's lots of fun. I really want it. I'm just like us. I want to tell Ira. I got my pussy. Here I go another thing. Now I have no money. If you eat the pages, you will get a headache. You will know.
No, we did it, sorry.
Thank you!
If I wrote a fanfic, it would be about Tyrion and a crowd. They are us. Put them off. I'm the Ashley. Boom them off!
This next game is going to be for both teams, actually. It's called Scenes from a Hat. And they're going to be handing off between each other, one at a time, acting out short little scenes that were submitted at the beginning of this panel. So I'll give them a second to set up.
So, for anyone that doesn't know, we were out at Fiesta Equestria a couple weeks ago, and we filmed a video that's actually being premiered at the Bronies Rec panel tomorrow 3. Plug. Anyways, my knee's been really bad and over the last 2 weeks, and for some reason I decided to do that slide. Great idea. So what do you guys think so far? All right, Drew Carey.
Are we all ready?
Okay.
Yes.
I'm ready now.
Trying to order these so that things don't fall over. All right. First one is Trixie on a blind date.
Who's this third one? Puppy Dog Tails? Stips and Stills and Puppy Dog Tails.
I got it.
It's a smart joke.
So you know they call me great and powerful for a reason.
We can't take the carriage. It has wheels.
I hope you like people who got defeated by alicorns.
Alicorn amulet growth enhancement.
Alright, next one. What happened to the Paris Sprites after they left Ponyville?
On to Catamount! On to Florida! Off to Hometown Buffet!
Off to Unicon!
Off to DashCon!
I hope we got an extra hour.
Yes. I gotta ask this one. What Spike does in Twilight's Crystal Castle when nobody else is around?
Oh my god.
Okay, so what's this rule 34 everyone keeps talking about?
Just got hands.
High five! High five! High five! High five!
She just stole my joke! Hands!
Thought they'd be bigger.
See, Bon Bon, I told you that you were wrong. You.
You've been waiting how long to do that?
I can finally count to five!
I can play one more than one note on the lyre.
How long has that been there?
This is a lot more painful than I anticipated.
I know this like the backside of my, oh my god.
I don't have to use hoof buds anymore.
All right, things you can say at Bronycon, but not at a wedding.
This is not the appropriate venue.
What are you doing with my waifu?
I'm hoping I get extra time with the ball pit.
That's terrible.
Hey man, your cosplay's extra furry.
What century is back?
Oh, you can't say that here either.
Expect plenty of spaghetti.
There's a surprising amount of neckbeards here.
How Luna and Celestia spend their free time.
All right, I'll go first. Hey, Celestia, guess what?
What?
It's a full moon tonight.
Is your refrigerator running?
Luna, please, lower down the moon.
Turn it down for what?
Unlikely cameos in My Little Pony.
Oh. I love you, you love me.
Hey everyone, Howard Stern here.
Wada wada $1! Billy Nays here with...
Is this Sweet Apple Acres?
No, this is Patrick.
Say to Princess Celestia, but not your significant other.
Let me tell you, that tattoo is hot.
I love your horn.
You're the light of my life.
At least she's on all fours.
Bad inspirations for Rarity's dresses.
And now my new Miley Cyrus line.
We'll call it the Lady Gaga line.
My new cloak inspired by the Black
Plague. That was horrible.
And now a finishing touch, just the fedora on top.
I let Sweetie Belle cook this line.
The first ball pit dress.
What is my
What is inside Trixie's hat?
I got nothing.
What is inside Trixie's hat? Is that lice?
Bum, 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 bum.
Oh, cool, I'm a Narnia.
You're in House Gryffindor. Made in China?
Angel, how did you get in here?
You're in House Black Gryffindor.
Oh, it's the script for Equestria Girls Free. I better burn this.
Secret Confessions of Big Mac.
Maybe?
Why am I named after a burger?
So maybe someday I'll actually tell people that I really do have a lot on my mind. There's a lot I want to say, but you know what? How are they going to handle it when I just never shut up? It's just always in my mind, always in my mind.
Nope. Am I the only pony out there that loves a plushie?
I mean, why Big Mac? Are they calling me fat? I don't know.
All right, let's give him a round of applause. Saber said something to me really quickly, but I didn't hear any of it. He's gone now. Saber, come back!
Cheer for Saber to come back!
Yes? I didn't hear what you said! You said something to me and it sounded important.
I sent me my fanfic!
I tried!
I was thinking we should do another game. Oh. What? What?
All right, well, the next game we've got on the list here is Heartfelt Song.
Yes.
Now, this is a new type of format, which we actually developed at NLP MSP. The way this is going to work, this is for Team Hash Browns. And basically, these two here are going to improvise a heartfelt ballad in each of them. And Gabe and the others are going to be improvising stanzas.
Now,
I think I'm thinking of two versions of this. I want to do one with Gabe to lay it down because he was the one who established this game at MSP. So I want a suggestion from the audience of a heartfelt song for Gabe.
Banana!
It's gonna be a heartfelt song made up on the spot about ice cold water. It's apparently only $1.
Vigilante of the Wild West. So we're going to sing about a third quarter.
a hero, a hard Christian. Gabe, how about you open this up with the first letter of this legendary hero?
Where would I be without water? I would be here, but a lot thirstier.
Gatorade, Powerade,
cannot quench my thirst. What I wanted was love, for it was
looking for him in the parking lot. We're not joking.
He probably thinks he's been arrested or something.
He probably has been.
You
a duty to the citizens of Baltimore, I think, to provide, you know, hydration.
Only $1.
Since this is, you know, this is Bronycon, this is the last convention before it's gonna air, I think this should be about rainbow rocks. What do you guys think? So, you guys ready? You wanna do this? You gonna do an Irish
team?
Yeah, yeah,
okay,
you guys. Rainbow
rocks.
Rainbow rocks.
Rainbow rocks. Yes, you do.
I'm partial to the funny version of her, but
rainbow rocks, go kick rocks. We like rocks.
I'm on fire.
Wow, what? Bell's rough start.
Can we start over?
Yes! Alright! Another equestrian girl. What were they thinking? Even Mae Larson, thank you.
This is a killing.
I can't believe the second one. They had wings.
Oh my.
And things
Hooves.
It's a battle of the bands.
I really worry. Is Flash Entry back?
I heard that they kiss. That would really suck.
Please prepare.
My fanfiction.
Supposed to be Lassie.
Oh, Equestria Girls is coming.
Better hide.
I'm gonna put my earplugs in.
Then I die.
It's really depressing.
It's just a show.
I'd rather drink some cyanide
than let it go.
It's just a movie.
The Hasbro's trying to kill us. Why would they do this?
They love us.
But Larson, he sucks.
I'm a lady.
Can't come so
teams.